Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Firstly, I'd just like to ask if there's anybody in here who's feeling worried, nervous, apprehensive, and afraid of what lies ahead. If you are, it's probably because you're me, because I think I am. Or it's because you just married Daniel Banks. Following the previous speeches, it's always a tough task, but I've given my best shot. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Chris, Daniel's best man and brother. I assume Pastor's best man anyway. Maybe I was entered into the best brother category. I guess the competition was slightly less fierce being the only brother. I'm quite happy that Daniel has finally admitted that I am the best man. Alex and Daniel, it's an honour to be here today on your special day. I'm so happy for you two. What a fantastic day it's been so far. I'm so glad so many family and friends could make it from as far up north as Scotland to as far down south as Southampton, and as far overseas as the Isle of Man. It's amazing the lengths people go to for a free meal. I'm sure you all agree how fantastic the bridesmaids look today. Mm. Having not met any of you before, it's clear you get on very well with Alex, and you have kept us sane in the lead up to the wedding. And from what I've heard, you've organised a cracking handy. So if we could make a toast, first toast goes to Lisa, Liz and Rebecca, the bridesmaids.
Bridesmaids.
You may not know, October the 22nd is a popular wedding day. Some of the greats who also share your date include Cindy James Brown, Cat Morgan Freeman, and tennis stars Andre Agassi and Steffi Graf, who in fact married each other. You'll be pleased to know that at least one of these marriages is still together. Daniel first asked me to do the honour of being best man, or should I say best brother, on their return from Mexico where Daniel proposed to Alex. I went to pick them up from Manchester Airport, holding the sign I made at a service station saying, Mr. and Mrs. Banks to be, standing before all the taxi drivers. And Daniel asked me within 5 minutes of seeing them to be best man. I think this is the single most organised thing that he's ever done, asking so soon after arriving back in the country. Those of you know Daniel, they were slightly laid back. Some say horizontal, he's also known as Captain Slave. As Daniel's mentioned already, Maureen introduced Alex to Daniel. What I didn't mention was Maureen showed Alex a photo of Daniel when he was on a TV episode with Soccer AM. Always win better. I'm just glad you scored that one. I'm just about to scroll out of this photo and he didn't suck my own dick. When they went on the first date, Daniel confided them some brotherly advice. He basically asked which was the best Eastern European car wash in the area. I know at this point he must have been keen and wanted to impress. After the first date, it was clear they got on, and the rest is history. Anyway, enough of the lovey-dovey stuff. As best man, it wouldn't be right if I didn't tell some stories about a groom. As Daniel's younger brother, it wasn't easy growing up with him. Apparently when I was born, he asked my mum and dad if we could send back. As this didn't happen, he persevered, and every time my mum used to show off the new baby in the street, he used to pull a hood over the brow and say, "You're not looking." As we grew up, I think you realised there were benefits of having a little brother there. The times before TV remotes were invented, he used to lie in bed and shout, Chris, come here. Me being as colourful as I was, used to walk in his bedroom and say, turn my TV off. You obviously grew to like me, though. I think you realised how useful I was. We had to get along and having our ups and downs along the way. We got into trouble with our parents quite regularly, doing things like playing football in the living room. I remember the time when the football hit an ornament duck and the head smashed up. In our desperate attempt for my mum not to find out, we glued the duck's head back on. I must say it was a few days before I got noticed. We also used to play snooker on a makeshift snooker table on mum's ironing board. I remember a particular incident where Daniel got a bit excited and put his snooker cue straight through the light fitting, making a perfect hole from one side to the other. This damage was a little bit more difficult to disguise it. Finishing school, Daniel gained the pension at Rolls Royce, where he has worked, or should I say attended the last 6 months. It's pretty spent some time when they had to learn, order some new workwear. His workmates gave him some advice what to mention when giving him his measurements, such as his waist and chest size, leg length, and most importantly, the address to the left. So Daniel, not knowing what that meant, went off to the Avenue, gave his measurements and said, "Here's my measurements, oh, and address to the left." The Avenue did skip bush. Daniel got embarrassed, turned to his workmates who were crippled over and laughed. Daniel's laid back last night, he accepted this joke and knew he'd fit well here. I'm just glad you didn't make the same mistake with another suit fitting, isn't it? So, on to the stag do. It was my responsibility to get 12 hungover lads from Luton to Berlin on a 4 a.m. flight. I still don't know how I made the flight when final boarding was called and the gate was a 15-minute walk away. On arrived in Berlin, we headed straight for the beer festival to join the locals in drinking a few beer steins, dancing on tables, singing along to classic German tunes in best German accents, falling off tables, and that was just down on the first night. Now you're blending in well with the locals, dressed in lederhosen. Which I think you secretly loved. But I'm not convinced you enjoyed the second night's fancy dress, did you, Daniel? Even the local police decided. Well, that's another story. You came away with a few cuts and bruises, but it's a fantastic weekend and I hope the other lads enjoyed it as much as I did. Daniel and I have done a lot over the years. Derby County has always been a joint passion of ours, and we've been week in, week out for season tickets. We're also the... We are also the founding members of the Farm Side football team, the Chicken Kiev. We have finally won the league for the first time last year. Admittedly, it was only Division 5. I'm saying that, I suppose we've done better than Derby County have recently. Also, a few years ago, Daniel had the patience to teach me to ski. I think he must have been regretting it a bit when he had to rescue me off one run we went on and I lost my bottle. But no, instead he found it hilarious. I think we've come on a bit since I'm normal, Daniel. Look at us now. I've followed in your footsteps over the years and you've taught me a lot, even down to our similar sense of humour. So if any of you don't like the content of this speech, blame Daniel. Now, moving on to Alex. I'm sure you'll all agree how fantastic she looks today.
Yeah.
I think it's a keep from the start for Daniel. I particularly liked you because you'd always laugh at my jokes where Daniel would just shake his head and call me an idiot. She had a great choice of interest with Daniel, such as travelling the world, music gigs, doing crazy distance, running events for fun, and of course football. Thank you for giving me the chicken message. I can honestly say you and Daniel are very compatible and are made for each other. I make Daniel happy the way I never could.
I'm glad about that.
Thank you for being a loving, caring, affectionate and intelligent wife. And Alex, you have gained a handsome, smart, witty new brother-in-law and a brilliant surname. Can I ask you all to stand and raise your glass to Mr. and Mrs. Banks. Mr. and Mrs. Banks.
Well done, Chris.